Hi, this is Julian from MinuteEarth. Microbes are incredibly tiny. Their name, microbe, literally means tiny life form. And to see them, you need a tiny life form seer, more commonly known as a microscope. Except, it's sometimes more useful to observe microbes from space. Well, at least observe their effects. That's because the impacts these tiny life forms have on our planet can be so huge that they're visible from satellites over 400 miles away, and that broader perspective can give us more useful information than we could ever hope to get by just using microscopes. For example, certain disease-causing microbes can infect plants, and since the plant's chlorophyll degrades as the plants die, turning their leaves brown, we can step way back and use satellites to measure changes in the visible and infrared light coming off forests and crops to tell whether groups of plants are healthy or dying. While we can use microscopes to observe the microbes infecting the plant tissue, using space-based data is significantly more efficient because we can inspect large swaths of land in minutes. In the US, forests cover a third of the land. But with satellite data, forest managers can easily prioritize monitoring on areas where dying and drying trees may be most likely to go up in flames. And farmers can decide whether they should continue expending resources on potentially disease-doomed crops without having to inspect acres of land on foot, which not only saves them money, but also saves the environment from wasted water and excess fertilizer. Satellites can also pick up chlorophyll reflected off huge blooms of another microbe, phytoplankton. The scale of these blooms would be impossible to document with microscopes, or even just from the Earth's surface, since it would take a ship 11 years to collect as much data on phytoplankton as a single satellite does every 2 minutes. And there's a lot we can infer from this data when paired with what we already know about these microbes, like the fact that the floating blooms of phytoplankton are sometimes home to the nasty bacterium that causes cholera. And when ocean water occasionally floods inland, the bacteria hitch a ride into rivers and lakes that people use for drinking, bathing, and cooking, killing tens of thousands of people each year. While we can collect samples from water sources and inspect them for the cholera-causing bacteria, satellite data showing a combination of warm waters, high ocean levels, and a concentration of phytoplankton can help us forecast cholera outbreaks before they reach these waterways, which can help save many lives. And satellites may soon help us find life on other planets, too. Looking at Earth, they've been able to identify patterns in salt-rich rocks that were caused by salt-loving microbes. And looking at Mars, satellites are now finding those same patterns in salt-rich Martian rocks, which suggests the same kind of microbes once lived on Mars. Using that knowledge, we've started to direct our microscope-equipped rovers to the most likely locations to find traces of life. So, satellites will never completely replace lab work and on-the-ground observations. We still need microscopes to learn more about how those bacteria work in the first place. But by using both microscopes and macroscopes, we can magnify our understanding of Earth and other planets.
This video was sponsored by the University of Minnesota, where students, faculty, and staff across all fields of study are working to solve the grand challenges facing society. One of these challenges is assuring clean water and sustainable ecosystems, which is easier to do when we can keep an eye on the microbes causing problems in our planet's water and vegetation. Professor Jeannine Cavender-Bares in the College of Biological Sciences and her team, including Professors Rebecca Montgomery and Jennifer Juswick in the College of Food, Agricultural, and Natural Resource Sciences, and postdocs Beth Fallon, Gerard Sapes, and Anna Schweiger have been developing new methods of detecting tree diseases using remote sensing technology. These tools have the potential to contribute to sustaining forest health nationally and globally. Thanks, University of Minnesota.